y'all. Goji Berry Terry here. It's Sunday morning, June 16th, 2017. And I'm just kind of slowly getting with it. Well, I shouldn't say slowly. I've been up since 5:30. And I think it's about 9:30 close to it. I've already juiced some watermelon julep, I call it. It's watermelon, peppermint, lemon, and it is delicious, and it's just perfect for the morning when you just want to meditate, pray, reflect, and just kick back. The reason I'm doing this video about why YouTube is because I've had some of my family members and friends ask me, why are you doing YouTube? Like I really have a lot of time to do YouTube. Oh, Molly's scratching. You got a little scratch. I'm doing YouTube for several reasons. I have a lot of my clients, patients, friends, family, contacts wanting to see some of my recipes. I'm a raw food chef. I'm also a health educator, healer of epigenetics, and if you don't know what that means, we'll get into that possibly later on, depending on if I'm led to do so. And a lot of reason is there's not enough of me, and so this is a way to reach a lot of people with my raw food recipes. Right now I'm mainly doing juicing recipes because this is day 46 of my juice fast feast solid food vacation. And I'm also getting asked, well, why are you doing that? Well, there are many reasons to why I'm doing this. However, I'll give you a few. To cleanse and purify thyself, as Dr. Gabriel Cousins would say. And there's quite a few health gurus out there that have done it and done it their way. I'm a food scientist, so I'm experimenting on me first to see how it goes, and so far so good. Man, oh man, I'll tell you what, you're in for a treat, as my friend John would say, and I say you're in for a treat and a surprise. It's awesome. I've had so many things occur, and I'm documenting everything, so eventually I'll share that with you all at some point. And it's just been an amazing experience. I'm shooting for 100 days or till I poop juice, whichever one comes first. And I know that sounds crazy, but you cannot believe how much stuff a person can store up over the years, not even knowing it. And I thought I was doing pretty good being a raw foodie, super foodie, vegan, whatever. And I went in stages with it. I started out, I've probably been on this journey 40 years. People go, well, how long have you been doing this? Well, it doesn't matter how long you've been doing it. It doesn't matter if you've been fully raw for years or if you've transitioned in a lot of directions and maybe gone off the path. That the key is to just do what you can do and get started. And if you want to improve your health, and that was the main reason I'm trying to take my health to the next level. I've done a lot with the raw food, superfood transformation and lifestyle. However, I was not where I wanted to be. And so this has helped me in so many ways, and I am going to a new level with it. So it's been a great journey, a great adventure, and I'm gonna share more about it with you as time allows. And some raw food recipes. I haven't been doing the raw food recipes because I really didn't want to be tempted to eat them while I'm on a juice fast, because I make some yummy stuff. But I do want to share those, and I promise y'all they're coming. I've made one raw food recipe the other day, I didn't taste it, but I had one of my little helper minions, Ginger James, tasted it, and he said it was awesome. it was a mango pineapple apple cobbler pie, and I used the pulp from some of the juicing I'd done. And so you can utilize the pulp. If you don't want to compost it and put it in your garden, you can make some wonderful treats. And so I'm going to start doing some of those. And I hope you guys will enjoy the channel and the recipes and the funny, goofy stuff. I did a tree yoga video with my daughter the other day when we were out hiking, and she got a big laugh out of that. I fell out of the tree. It was funny. And it happens, not typically, but, you know, I spoke it, so naturally it happened. But it was fun. We had a good time. And I'll share some of that stuff, and you guys might get a good laugh, or you might get a good recipe, or who knows. And no, I'm not doing this for financial gain. YouTube doesn't pay me. I don't care if I have a million subscribers, and you know, it's just one is all I'm after. But I hope my contacts will eventually, when I get an opportunity to share this with everyone, that they will subscribe to the channel and get some great recipes as well as some good laughs, and maybe even learn a few things. I don't know. We'll see. I learn things every day from my 2-year-old grandson sometimes. He's cute. He's precious. He is precious. He loves Nanny's watermelon juice. And he loves Nanny's seasoned French fries. I'm gonna do a video on those. They're raw, of course. They're not really French fries, but they look like French fries. And they're yummy. So we'll do a video on that. I'll do a few videos on how to juice. Right now I'm doing a lot of juicing, and I'm documenting all my juice recipes for my book. I am going to have a raw food juicing, not cookbook at some point, but preparation book. There's lots of recipes out there, y'all. Just get started. And mine are unique. I've been working on them for 6 years now and hope to have it done pretty soon. We'll see, but who knows? My kids may publish it when I die. It's not about rich and fame and fortune for me. It's about leaving a legacy for my children and their children's children, and maybe making a big difference in their lives. Who knows? We'll see. But meanwhile, I just wanted to let y'all know why I'm doing YouTube. And there you go. That's it. So, we will end with my usual little namaste, shalom, sat nam, and peace. Happy trails till we meet again. Enjoy the videos. They're free, and they're raw, and they're just me.